Welcome back, everyone, to Let's Play Rule the Waves 2 as Japan. So, we have a new aircraft carrier. It's currently under design, the Tsunami. It's going to carry a very large amount of aircraft. But that's it's really only going to make up for our obvious shortcomings in the surface fleet side of things. Because although we do have four really good Daigoji dreadnoughts, we are really sorely lacking in the surface ship field compared to a lot of our, even the people who have the same or even a lower budget. I don't understand how Germany is, well, I mean, I guess we can just look at the tonnage situation. They're fielding a total tonnage of 575,000, let's say. So let's call it 600,000, and we're fielding, I'll even be generous and say we're fielding a tonnage of 300,000. They have less budget than us, but they are fielding twice the tonnage of battleships and battlecruisers. And just before we go on, let's also remember that battlecruisers per ton are usually more expensive to maintain. I'm not exactly sure. I really wish I understood how this is happening, how it's possible. And normally I would say, okay, well, we got a lot of carriers, but actually, the reality is, we don't have that many carriers. We have three, they have three, and ours are bigger. Those are probably conversions, though, and if they are, they're probably, you know, much more maintenance than they need to be. I don't know, I have a lot of questions. We have more light cruisers than they do, but, I mean, just if you kind of think of total budget as roughly somehow linear, it's not quite, but somehow a function of total tonnage, monotonic with total tonnage, let's say, something like that, I don't know. Yeah, this is just a very strange situation that Germany, somehow, with less of a budget, has more ships than us. Now, where's the difference? Okay, so we see at least 60 submarines difference. And that is huge, right? Well, it's 20 per month. Let's say 30 per month, just because some of them are not coastal. Some of them are normal submarines. So, I mean, most of them are coastal. But let's just try to be generous and say 30. So that's 1,800. So 1,800 monthly balance goes to submarines. Is that correct? Because that is a pretty big difference. Okay, so now it's starting to make sense. We have a lot of submarines, they don't. Submarines are expensive. And the cost per month of a submarine actually is more than a destroyer. I'm not sure if that's true in reality, but yeah, it's actually much more than a destroyer. No, it's about the same. Okay, so a destroyer and a submarine being about the same, it still seems a little bit expensive from a for a submarine standpoint, because submarines in general have to kind of be efficient about things. So, but that's at least it's not a crazy figure. At least we're starting to understand where the but 1,800 would supply us with, let's say, even on reserve fleet, 1,800 would supply us with 7 of these. Okay, so 7 Gachimuchis. I don't know. Yeah, I guess it's starting to work out. I don't think the numbers quite add up perfectly, but it's not hugely imbalanced when I look at it that. Whoa. Okay, it is still hugely imbalanced. Because that's 7. If I add 7, that means that they're still over us by 8 ships, and it's 8 battlecruisers, which should have higher maintenance. Okay, so I'm back to being not understanding this, but anyway, well, we don't need to think about that for too long. Selling us something, then the answer is always yes, we'll take it. Okay, we'll probably wait a few months to get more funds going. The Oregon, 15-inch guns, 11.5-inch belt, 24 knots. Yeah, this looks like a very nice ship. But it's not something that I don't think we can, we stand a chance against that It's not impossible. Oh man, we gotta get those. They want to sell us something? Yes. Just in time for us to go negative. So how do we solve that? We do the usual. We halt a ship. I think I'll halt this one this time because for the moment we are doing okay. We don't have war coming, so we don't need this ship in service quite yet. Okay, that should be fine. And next month we will be able to start doing our carrier as well. Okay, yeah, by all means, France, take this technology. Okay, let's go to rework the design. We're expecting not to actually rework it, but let's look. Okay, I don't think inclined belt matters on this thing. Why? How is this negative 22? What is happening here? Did it have an inclined belt? What difference? What changed? Maybe it was one of the damage control technologies? So let me... I'm not going to edit this. I don't think there's anything I want to edit because this is overweight. I mean, if I, anything, I want to save it as a new design. But okay, let me just rely on the fact that I'm not an idiot, or hope that I'm not an idiot. Let's go to the tsunami and open it. I don't understand. Did I just design it like an idiot? Well, first of all, I'll tell you what, that superstructure is annoying. Why is that happening? Oh my god, I'm on version 1.20. This is hilarious. I upgraded to version 1.20, and guess what? I'm sure that the treatment of something has changed slightly, and now my ship is no longer making weight. We're going to build it anyway. I don't know if it's a good idea or not, so I will only build two. Let me get up my list of names. Turns out we don't need to do any kind of looking up of names at all because the ship classes, the carriers, other carriers are for ship classes, so I just draw from the normal list. We'll see who the lucky winner is, the Suki. So it's the Tsunami and the Suki. I like that. They're nice sister ship names. Easy for me to remember. So we're building two of them, and that's because I forgot I'm already building this other one, but we'll just halt the 14-month one. Let me resume and halt this one, wait for a little bit of budget. New docks. No, I don't think we're going to get it. We're going to have to mothball something. Or reserve fleet. We aren't putting ships back on reserve fleet. And somebody mentioned that to me. And also I have an obsolete light carrier or light cruiser that, yeah. We like budget. New fighter prototypes. Okay, good. Especially if we're... Wow. The one we have in service is really good. Yep, it's better. Only downside, of course, is the reliability, but... It's pretty amazing how slow the progress of aircraft has been so far. Okay, well, that's fine. We'll just leave it as is then. Okay, so let's go back and let's do the refit on the ones that are obsolete. And I would consider scrapping these, but they do function pretty darn well outside, even beyond their, like, what you would expect their functional range should be. These are still pretty effective ships. We'll put director firing on them, increased elevation. They have quality 1 6-inch guns. I like quality one, so that's, we'll just leave it like that. Oh my gosh, we have mines yet? I don't think any of our ships have mines. Okay, so we got those two. They will rebuild. Hopefully none of them were being used for anything. We'll put these on reserve. It's going to save us a lot of money, I think. We mothballed this because now that our carrier is being designed, we need to go to air groups and scrap it. So, take you and you and drag you to reserve. And now we can scrap the Ontake. Thank you for your service. And maybe you would imagine us selling that off to a second world nation or something like that. Like Brazil comes to mind. Here, have this carrier. It also has guns on it. But we don't want that. We want it only to have aircraft. Okay. How am I feeling about this? Yeah, we'll continue. Well, this will give us more budget. And I think we're ready for war. By that I mean, we do have our Daigojis out, and this one is only 4 months away. So we're doing okay. It looks like we'll get 1 month in here, knock it down to 3 months. The number of aircraft and carrier capable air units exceeds our capacity to train pilots. The number of aircraft and carrier capable air units exceeds our capacity to train a pilot's experience will suffer. What? What does this come from? Somebody will have to let me know. And that is interesting. Oh, are these carrier capable? Yes, so they probably have to be based on a carrier. Okay, that's fine if it's only those two pilots suffering. But I don't understand, we're paying maintenance for them. Why would it suffer? Huh. I don't know. Carrier capable air units exceeds the capacity of our training facilities. This will slow down the training of... Yeah, I don't understand this. We are not over on any of these. And these guys are, I assume, on reserve. They are. I assume this reserve is on reserve. Okay, I'm just gonna ignore it for now. I don't know what to do. We're gonna have a new carrier out for those guys eventually. I guess I could just scrap them. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's the alternative, is if it's gonna hurt everything else, we'll just scrap them. Okay, fine, we'll just disband you. And now you won't have any more warnings for me. Fair enough, works for everyone. 11 months away, I know, but we'll halt this one. I'll get the other one out first. Okay, let's see. It's not as good. Now let's go back over here. We have 2,000 plus, so this probably is doable for another month. Yes. We're just gonna keep eking them out as eking. It really is eking out. Just barely, little by little, we'll get it done. 7,000. I'm just looking for people who are now going to be obsolete. Chunchamarus are 5 years. That's fine. The Coons are 1924. Also 5 years. Still acceptable by my standards. When you refit these, do you have to move the crew? I don't think so, right? If you scrap them, you do. But if you reserve or refit them, do they lose their crew? I can't remember. I ought to test it with just one so we don't lose too much. Let me just look real fast. Who did? I don't think any of these aircrews have seen action. They're all fair. Yeah, okay. Then let me do it right with the namesake real fast. I don't think there's anything we're going to want to do. I'm very happy to see we have Torpedo Defense 1. These are actually really good light carriers. Really, really good. I suspect that they will be with us until the end of the game. Really good. Oh, we can get dual purpose as well. Oh, that's really nice. And add another light anti-aircraft gun, sure. Increased elevation, not really going to help much, but we'll do it. How much would... No, we can't go to 34, 35 anyway. 34 is the limit, which is really cool. Okay, we could even bulge these, which would lower it down to 22, speed of 22. That's cool, it actually extends the... Oh, it's doing that because the displacement got kicked up. But it actually shouldn't do that then, because the bulging would not happen that direction. It would happen on the sides. Yeah, I don't think we need to do the bulging, that's fine. Should we add more guns? So for some reason we can add guns on both sides, at least in the other... Or we can at least add a starboard midship gun. Is this acceptable? Yeah, insufficient topside space for that because I just added a new thing, but it only has to drop by one and now it's acceptable. I guess we're gonna have to move this funnel, unfortunately. Okay, a little bit awkward. She's not quite right. I hate this. There. Yeah, whatever. We'll just leave it. So we have another 4-inch gun, just dual purpose. That's the only reason why I want it. And we're down to 59. We still have the ability to do something. We have a little bit of extra weight just kicking around. I just don't see anything. Minesweeping gear? Can put minesweeping gear on a light carrier? I assume you cannot. Okay, good. That is good. Yeah, I think she'll just have a little bit of extra weight. And there's nothing. Oh, I mean, I guess we could kick up our number of fire control positions. With 4-inch guns, I'm not sure that's really super necessary. But with the extra weight, why not? So we'll do it. And okay, we'll just save this. Rebuild this, and let's see, did it go away? Okay, we'll see when they come back out. I think it did. Okay, we got more money. All forward main armament, awesome. So the next ship is going to be, it's going to be all forward guns. That will be probably the final Japanese battleship. And I'll try to make that one a fast one, maybe like 27, 28 knots. Maybe 28 knots. That'd be nice and quick. We'll need to build up the dock size. We don't have the funds to do that right now, but, you know, eventually. And it's actually great. We're squeaking by with people on active duty. Not on my watch. In fact, you guys get... No, you don't get mothballed. I mean, I guess I... Yeah, I'm going to have to mothball you. In fact, I'll mothball all of the old ships just to save a little bit of money. I'm going to assume that we'll have enough advance notice. And let's mothball these guys as well. I'm going to assume we're going to have enough advance notice before improved director, just in time before we go to war. So somebody has better torpedo bombers than us. That is something that I want to focus on, so I think we will go ahead and start designing a new one. We haven't had a great amount of success with this, but let's go with reliability here. No. Don't be... Let's go back to the the usual. Range and speed. That's all we really want. And reliability will just come in time, I guess. Yeah. I think it did eat those aircraft. France and Russia, oh man, boy, who hasn't Russia signed an agreement with at this point? I think they've signed it with Germany. No, was it just Britain twice? I think it was just Great Britain. I don't know, or was it France previously? Well, I mean, that's not good. Was it France and I don't remember. I think Great Britain collapsed and then Russia stayed, continued the fight. I have like Germany in my head. This series has been going on so long, man. I can't even remember who we fought anymore. All right, so we have the newest battleship out. That explains the positive funds. We'll go ahead and build our dock size up. And we could get more aircraft carriers, but I'm actually going to wait on that because I don't know how this is going to work with these ships being overweight. So I want to wait and see. All right, this is a decent battleship, decent dreadnought. 23 knots, okay, they're all kind of matching our speed. Is that what we did? Improved firefighting equipment? Wow, something which Japan historically would have benefited from, I think. Okay, so working up just is another way of saying reserve. And... And an active fleet is only for people... yeah, there's the problem. So we'll... The older ones should go to... Is it all of you guys are the older ones? Oh, we never finished doing this. We need these four to go back down to Southeast Asia, move to Southeast Asia. So there it is. And now you guys next turn will get refit, and then, yeah. Wait. Yeah, yeah, then that's done. And Northeast Asia. So you, this group, these are the heavier hitters. And we have this size over here. These guys should all be reserve fleet. Asamaru, well, mothball, one mothball, that's fine. So our tonnage in Southeast Asia, let's just take a look at it, see how we're doing there over there. Are we over? Are we right at the right amount? Yeah, we are. Okay, good. 750 means we have technically one ship more than we need, but that's still cutting it pretty close. I guess we might as well just move one more ship out. We're going to save 12, but Tortuga or Tortogo is willing to pinch those pennies. I'll save that 12 a month. No reason not to. Northeast Asia. So next month. Okay. No, we don't want to lower tensions with Russia. Not at all. Superimpose B mount on light cruisers. Well, it may be time for light cruisers soon, but this game, again, does not emphasize light cruisers or heavy cruisers when you get to the end game. You know, it's funny, because Rule of the Waves 1, I felt like it did. I felt like in Rule of the Waves 1, you really benefited from building light cruisers. But not in Rule of the Waves 2, and I can't really... It's funny, you should, since you should get dual-purpose guns and like have like floating flak batteries, basically, but I don't really get the sense that they work that well in this. Okay, let's mothball you. Woohoo! 12 more monies. We have these guys on reserve, reserve, mothball, reserve, active. Okay, so you're done. Let's put you to mothball, and let's just make sure that this... your guys are actually okay. We'll put you to reserve. M, I guess, is mothball, which is funny. It's not active. It's not reserve. It's mothball, which I'm not sure what the difference is, though. Appears like there's no difference. Maybe it's just showing. I mean, I can't tell. I thought that this letter in parentheses was representing the aircraft, not the ship itself. Nonetheless, if that's the case, that we don't have to worry about that, let's rebuild these as well. I may even build more coons. Like, these are... I really find them very decent, like, carriers. We'll probably end up doing stuff like deploying those over to, like, South Pacific and stuff like that. Later air-launched torpedoes. I would love those. Absolutely. Japan needs those. How we doing? 6 more months. And the carriers are only 15 months away, so we're getting close. Boy, that's exciting. New cruiser from France. It had to be France. But France is a good... I think without the Russian-France-French alliance, they would be an excellent opponent. With the Russian-French alliance, it's not quite as appetizing. Just because Russia will be annoying. But maybe we can end up getting more points, defeating them both. I don't know. Okay, so we can gain budget, lose prestige, and don't need to raise tensions, or we can get prestige and tensions. This is so... I would always do this, but for a rare moment, I'm going to not do this, because a role play, you would never do this in Japan. So I'm going to do this one. And the net result should be more or less the same, an increase in budget, but it's not an increase of budget, like base budget or whatever. It's not even base, but just like the allocation of government resources. I guess it's the same because the government allocation increases with tensions. Excuse me. On reduction tiers, okay, that's increased endurance, I think. Mine rails on CLND, that's very nice. Okay. New torpedo bomber. Oh, I thought this was the improved torpedo, but no. Okay, we're looking really good here. Our reliability is maybe not reliable. So we'll just pick the best one, see how the, oh wow, you have very long range. Okay, you're the slowest, but you have the longest range by a sizable amount. Now, at 160, we're getting to the point where I think we can even get by without that. Otherwise, I mean, I think this one in the middle is the best bet because it has the highest maneuverability, highest toughness, highest maximum speed. So it's a really good aircraft in every way, except that its range is a little bit lower. Now, what is our current? 263. So that would be faster, but lower range, but much better. I think we're going to build this one. I think we're going to go with the Kawanishi. I mean, so this bottom one is, I just, you know, in every way an improvement in speed, an improvement in range. But now you get into this muddied water. Is firepower worth more than maneuverability and toughness? Probably not. But this one has both, and even higher toughness. So I'm going to go with this one. Yeah, let's do it. Okay, it's being delayed immediately. Funny. Not so funny. We're actually racking up a fair amount of funds, so that's good. More carriers. Okay, those guys have okay, there's the increased endurance, good. Hull construction, quality 1, 12-inch guns, that's actually really nice. All right, let's take a look at everything going on here because we got a bunch of people in active fleet and I forgot to fix all this. You guys go to reserve. You get upgraded. And we still have some people in active, but they're in Southeast Asia. They have to be there. And I'll get the other ones to go back down there too, even if we have to pull up some other ships, just in case we have surprise attack opportunities.
Oh,
I almost forgot. We wanted a new Corvette. Oh my gosh, I would have forgotten. Okay, so we'll just automatically design this for a moment. So our old one, let me cancel this and drop down. Our old one has Colonial Duty, which we might just leave in the hands of the Asama Maru, but it has minesweeper stuff, no mines, and because of that, it only has two ASW. Okay. Now, if I remember correctly, 900 is the maximum. Because that allows you to do increased storage and all those things. So, do we want to do, is this going to be the one that, we should basically have a minesweeping variant, which we unfortunately need now because we can't build, we need to, I only really want to build more Asama Marus, but I can't because we'd have to build the old version and then upgrade it all the way to 1924. I don't know why they don't let you. They used to let you just build directly the revised versions, which makes sense. It's not like if you put a revision on a ship, you can't just build it that way from scratch. If anything, it should be better. And like we're letting the game abstract that the ship would still be worse under a refit, but I don't know. So, I mean, it just comes up to this big question. Do I want minesweeping gear or ASW? Can't do both well. And I don't think we can put mines on these, right? Yeah. Okay, good. So, let's build one of the minesweepers. Okay, I've convinced myself. Let's build one of the minesweepers. Okay, we'll put it at 17 knots. It's a minesweeping ship. 600 tonnage is fine. That's why I made the other ones, right? Yeah. We'll do the same kind of thing, actually. We'll do Colonial Duty. Colonial Service. Medium range. Yep, looks like it. This thing has 5-inch guns. that might be a bit of overkill. We'll give it 4-inch guns. It does not need anti-aircraft. I'm sorry. Just give it a lot of ammo. We'll give it an aircraft. No, obviously not. Yeah, I think it's fine as is. We're basically just increased. How much is this? I mean, we have tons left over anyway. We might as well. Yeah, it's a good way of viewing it. We might as well. I mean, in some sense, we might as well would also work for speed, but that also increases the maintenance. 19 knots is not that fast. How much maintenance is 39? Complement is only increased by 1. I think I'll do the 19 knots. We'll call this the improved Osama Maru is now the Houghton Maru. Okay, I basically think that's it. Coal, oil, one of them might cost more, right? Technically, oil decreases the crew complement. Okay, let's see how... But the machinery weight and cost goes up. So I don't know, it's like one extra person shoveling coal, but I guess do they cost as much as repairing the engine? I don't know. I'll do coal. Just seems to make more sense to me. Fire control. Well, it's a little bit weird, but we actually do have the money for it. I mean, the space for it, but I'm looking at the money. 1478. Yeah, that is expensive. Local only. We don't care. 4-inch guns. Yeah, we're fine there. Okay, good. So that's good. Increased elevation. Why not? Okay. And yeah, we'll save this. Wait a month. Okay, so it's 5 million. No, we're not going to do this because it'd be 5 million to add that better fire control. Go for the win. We have 11-inch quality zero. That's really nothing to write home about. I'm just going to go to the build screen with this. And we'll get 12 of them. Okay, improve director before I forget. And let's focus on the... Oh, let's not do the Daigojis until we have all of them out. So we'll do the Gachimuchis first. Yeah, all these ships are messed up. They weren't like this before. It's a little bit annoying, actually. AA positions appears to have been changed as well. I think we can get around this by just doing that, which is fine. And we can increase that. Okay, that's fine. Oh, these can be dual purpose now? Yes. Okay, so this is actually big then. We'll drop down the number, I guess this number. These are the Gachimuchis. Let's think about this. I think we'll drop down the secondaries. Okay, so instead of having 9, they have 8 per side, but we've retained the number of tertiary guns, which is, I think, very important. And we actually increased the total amount of light anti-aircraft fire significantly. This seems to make sense. I think I like this. 23 knots, and that fits with the 23 knot Daigojis. This is perfect. Even if they mix and match, oh, it's going to be so nice that... Unfortunately, this is coal and the other ones are oil, but at least they share the same top speed at the beginning of the fight. I think everyone here knows how much I hate when the battle generator mixes my fleets up. So we'll get these guys to go in. That's going to take a hefty chunk of our budget, but it's certainly necessary to do. These guys are mothballed, and you know, tensions are not that high, so let's wait for those guys to get back before we do anything else. They're interested in buying, by all means. Aviation pundits are ecstatic. It's not how you spell it, but ecstatic about the new aircraft type medium bomber. Ah, interesting. Improved power training and elevation eliminates rate of fire for guns below 8 inches in turrets. Wow, is it really taking that long for us to get that? My goodness. Okay, so let's immediately go to air types and request a medium bomber. Range and speed are exactly the two that I was thinking of. We can do range and we can do reliability though. See if that makes any difference. Ooh, the new flying boat has good reliability. That is gonna make it king of the hill. I don't think I even care about the increased range of the Yokosuka. We'll wait to see what the reliability of it is, but I suspect that we're gonna obsolete the Yokosuka. You're not obsolete. Why are you not being built? There's 24 on, well, in stock, I guess, but why aren't they being built? Huh. They are worse. I guess it is a worse aircraft. Okay. I don't really want to obsolete the better aircraft. I just would prefer that, yeah. Yeah, I mean, it's nice to have only one aircraft. I think I read somewhere in one of the recent posts that only one version of an aircraft type is built at a time. So from that perspective, you're probably better off only having one version even in service. I mean, if you're taking an old one and obsoleting it, you shouldn't immediately... Yeah, I mean, I guess that's what you'd do. And then they would stay in service for a little bit while the other ones got replaced. Actually, we have a decent monthly balance still. Let's build a few more of these Corvettes, though. That always makes me feel a little safer. Eventually, we're going to need some ASW, but mines are also pretty annoying, so... Okay, our ship Tokugawa. Ah, finally, the last one. Okay, so... Russia, thank you. There's an internal upheaval in Northern Korea. Remember that this happened recently to South Korea? Russia is apparently sending a force there, ostensibly to restore order, but it's likely they have far-reaching plans. What do you recommend? Well, look, the ideal here is that we issue an ultimatum demanding that they back down, and then they don't. That's the ideal. So let's do that. Okay, well, we're about to go to war with Russia. So let's get everyone up. Let's just mobilize everyone. And let's go to the air bases as well. Boy, that would have been the best if they had... I mean, I shouldn't be too sour about it because we've already taken South Korea. But that would have been so cool. I probably should have just let them have it. Yeah, okay, in hindsight, I can't rewind time. It's a minor thing, this is a game, but boy, I am already kicking myself that we didn't just let them take it so that we could take it from them. Okay, well, live and learn. Okay, we know. Bummer, though. These guys are all ready for a refit. That's one way of getting them into active fleet, just having them refit. Improved director. Not going to cost us too much, and we have plenty of weight remaining here. Oh, dual purpose time. Okay, I think that that's mostly due to improved director. No, it's not. Let's start over. Okay, we're at 35. How much is doing this? Yeah, it costs 2,000 to make this dual purpose, and pretty expensive to boot. We'll drop down the secondary guns, which is okay. 9 per side is fine, and then we'll take this up to improve director. Well, it's a much better ship the way we've done it now, but yeah, we'll put directors on the secondaries as well. I don't know why that wasn't done already. And is this the one with the... Yeah, this is crazy that we have 4 float planes here. This is really nuts. insufficient. Okay, drop it down. Should be good. And it is good now. Yeah, we'll get rid of secondary guns essentially. I mean, destroyers are becoming much, much less of an issue at this point, and now aircraft are going to start becoming the problem. So we want to sacrifice secondary guns for tertiary guns. Should we do that even more? Okay, we can actually fit this many guns total. We just need to bring this number down again. And I think, is this worth it? Losing light anti-aircraft for the dual purpose? I don't actually know. And you know why? It's because dual purpose is obviously good for protecting others, but I'm not sure how effective it is. I don't think it helps at all in the actual attack. So, you know, I might actually undo that. So you get 3 light anti-aircraft guns for 2 dual purpose guns, but they will also help each other more. Oh, I can see this going both ways. Otherwise, we can drop this down to 8 6-inch guns per side, which is probably okay. I'm trying to think, where are we going to spend the extra weight? And look at that, the video is already over 40 minutes. Wow, we have 2. This thing is awesome. This Daigouji is awesome. It has 4 float planes that it launches in 2 waves of 2. That's really cool. So how about that? No, I don't really like that. I'd rather keep that the same. Okay, well, we'll just leave it as this. 37 light anti-aircraft guns is still a sizable number. And then we have the dual purpose. Actually, the dual purpose right now are not even going to function that well. Because we don't have directors for them. And hopefully we'll get that soon. So we'll just have a little bit of weight remaining. It's just the way it goes. Unless, yeah. I wouldn't really want to do that anyway. Okay, so let's rebuild these. And that is truly expensive, but hopefully they get out before our war with Russia breaks out. And actually, they don't even need to be there for the first turn. They can be gone, since the surprise attack is all we should have to worry about. We're still missing those destroyers. We have 4 in Southeast Asia. We would prefer if a few more than 4 were down there. We'll probably just start moving some stuff manually. Like, what do we have in Northeast Asia? We have these guys. Let's move all these old ships down to South. Or maybe they're actually the best candidates for the surprise attack. 6 torpedo tubes. Yeah, they're all good. I mean, if they have 6 torpedo tubes, they're pretty good. I think I'll keep the light carriers on reserve. Does that change their air groups as well? This is a curious thing. Did that change them back to active? No. Yeah, this is bizarre. We'll keep their, I think we're keeping their air groups on active while we keep the ships themselves, their crew, on reserves. Maybe. I'm not sure how it's working. All right, how many more months before our carrier comes out? Boy, we have a lot of stuff in here now suddenly. That's all those corvettes. 10 months? Okay. Well, they won't fight in this battle. I mean, in this war. Or maybe, I mean, if it goes on for a while, they will, but you know who will, and that's definitely the light carriers, which I want to keep in Northeast Asia. Okay, if it's a war against Russia, then we will attack ships here, yes. So this is a good idea. They have very little, but we should sink everything. So, here we go. Oh, boy. Well, I mean, I guess it has to be Russia. Anybody else risks, you know, a 3-way or at least a 2-way war developing anyway. We're ready to go to war with them, so let's just do it. I mean, we already activated our whole fleet. It would almost be bad if nothing. Okay, yeah, well, that's gonna happen. So we'll see how this is gonna play out next turn. I have some ideas. I have a guess, a strong feeling how things will happen, but we'll wait for next turn and next video to figure that out. So for now, thanks for watching, and until the next one, take care.